Yeah, yeah, no, they actually did really well on those state exams.
Dude, check it out. Eavesdropper found an email from Simon's boyfriend calling her soft serve Simon. That's not funny.
Hey, here's a post about Token. Token blacks private jet photos. I'm not looking at that. Come on, dude, it's pretty funny. It wouldn't be funny if that website posted something about you. I wouldn't care. Exclusive. Stan Marsh thinks Elise Thompson has a hot butt crack. What? In an email sent yesterday to Kenny McCormick, Stan Marsh wrote, "Dude, you should have been in EE today. Elise Thompson's butt crack was totally jealous." He went on to call her butt crack, quote, "nice," and then the whole experience was, quote, "pretty awesome."
Kenny! Kenny, what the fuck? How did Eavesdropper get a hold of my email to you?
I don't know.
Did you just leave your emails open for everyone to read?
No.
That was a private email from me to you.
Ship released. Engines engaged.
No, I was telling Kitty he would like it. So you have any idea how embarrassed I am? And it was just a quick email to Kitty. New stories pop up on Eavesdropper every hour. People are going to forget all about this.
So you didn't email anybody else about Elise Thompson's butt crack, right?
This is an issue of trust and privacy. We have to all work together to put an end to Eavesdropper once and for all. Yes,
detecting hostile scan. Charging.
I've done an extensive profile, and I've narrowed it down to somebody in this very room.
Ready to engage.
And whoever you are,
Four, three, two, one, engage.
Just a second. I believe we discussed a little matter of my payment. I'm not letting you guys screw me over again. Give me what I wanted, now.
All right, fine. Bring her in, Adler.
Target shields online.
Body charging.
ready to engage. 3, 2, 1, engage.
56, 57, 58, 59, 50, 51, 52. Oops, that worked out. All right, you got your rich guy, and this is the porter, and they're in this big hotel. And the rich guy said, I'd like to have some guys to come play poker with me here in my room. And the porter said, yes, sir, boss man, I'll go see what I can. Want to cut the cards? Just straight cut them. $2. He said, now, I've been to a lot of places, and it's a really good service. He said, how do you do that? He said, well, boss man, I got friends on 6th Street, 7th Street, and 8th Street. He said, well, you think you could get us some ladies to come up here and keep us company? He said, I don't know. You want to cut them, Kenny?
Charging.
And he come back and he said, I got you four guys.
Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Have you checked for me? I said, sure. How much is this? It's $40. He said, I'll just cut. One street. The porter come back. He said, I got you the check cash. I got you four $10 bills. I hope that's all right. He said, that's fantastic. Here's $10 for you. There's $2 $5. He said, how about some whiskey? Is it too late for you to get whiskey? He said, never too late for whiskey. That whiskey, I got you 4/5 of Ace Brand whiskey. He said, that's fantastic. Here's $2 more for you. He said, how old are you anyway? He said, I'm 46. He said, well, you don't look a day over 35. He said, you married? He said, yeah, I got 7 kids. I got 4 boys and 3 girls. Did you ever play any poker? He said, yeah, I belong to a club, the 48 Club, we call it. He said, well, I never can win. I get hands like this. I mean, you get 4 9s and can't win? He said, yeah, some song that you'll come up with, I like this. Thanks to Zeke. Well, that's it. Adios.
We were running out of time. The flames were rising, the sun was going down, hunger was at an all-time high. The burgers were a little well done.
Request granted.